Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today class we are going to discuss about V by F control method. This is the one of the powerful method to control the speed control of induction motor. So induction motor speed control, already we have discussed, that is the basic method, stator voltage control method. In that stator voltage control method, so we are going to vary the input voltage. The input voltage is given to stator winding, so that by varying the input voltage, the induction motor speed also varies. So by varying the input voltage, the speed control can be achieved by varying the input voltage. So second method is the voltage by frequency control. So this is the one of the powerful method to control the speed control of induction motor. So we know the relations of N is directly proportional to 120 F by P, or N equal to 120 F by P. So from this relation, if frequency increases, so what will happen? Speed also increases, your torque decreases. This is the first one. So frequency increases, if we increase the frequency, speed increases and torque decreases. So we know that from the expression, torque expression, T is directly proportional to V square. Already we know that T is directly proportional to V square, that is the stator voltage control. Already we derived that expression, T is directly proportional to V square. So if I am going to increase the voltage value, so what will happen? The torque value also increases. So torque value increases. So by combining these two features, so we are going to achieve a speed control method. That is, the speed increases. I am going to increase the speed, but the torque is kept same. But the speed increases, which is known as the V by F control. This is the V by F control. So that is by combining these two features. So N equal to 120 F by P, if frequency increases, speed increases, torque decreases. This is the first one. Second expression, T is directly proportional to V square. If I am going to increase the voltage value, torque value increases. So by combining these two features, we are going to achieve a control designed by the speed increases and the torque is, I am going to keep the torque same. This method is known as voltage by frequency control, or V by F control method. So let me go for speed torque characteristics of the three phase induction motor. So let us consider the reference point 1. So here the voltage is V1, frequency is F1. This is for fan type load. Figure 1 shows that, that is the 1 shows the fan type load. So the reference operating point is 1. So it is indicated in the curve number 1. So here I am going to increase the frequency value. That can be given F2. So what will, I am going to increase the frequency value, but the voltage is kept constant. That is second one, V1 is kept constant, but frequency is new frequency which comes F2. So what will happen? The motor speed increases. But the torque decreases. So frequency increase panna enna agum solirukom, speed increase agum, torque decrease agum. So your torque is decreases, so that maximum torque decreases but the speed increases, right? But here the steady state point cannot be achieved. Steady state point, that is the dotted line, load is given, that your second characteristics which comes to below of the dotted line. So the steady state point cannot be achieved. Steady state point can be achieved above the load characteristics, or that is the load dotted point. So right, so this is indicated in the point number 2. So next, so what I am going to do, I am going to keep the constant frequency. So frequency F2 cannot be changed, but the voltage is, I am going to increase the voltage. So third one, I am going to keep the frequency new value, same value F2, but increase the magnitude of V2. So if I am going to increase the voltage V, what will happen? Your torque value increases from that previous expression. So from this, so your voltage increases, what will happen? Torque value increases. So if I am going to frequency increases, speed increases, but torque value decreases. Your second characteristic, second curve, so V cannot be changed, but frequency, new frequency can be achieved. So your torque value decreases. But third one, your frequency kept constant, but what about the voltage value? I am going to increase the voltage value. So what will happen? Your torque value increases. A steady state, a new steady state point can be achieved. So this is the one of the powerful method. So I am going to vary the V by F ratio. So if I am going to change the speed control of induction motor, simultaneously V by F ratio can be fixed. So simultaneously corresponding voltage value, corresponding what about the frequency value, what about the frequency value, corresponding voltage. So by fixing the V by F ratio, the speed control can be achieved. So the torque can be given here. So here this is the speed control characteristics. If I am going to maintain a V by F is constant, your characteristics will be like that, right? So here, so if I am going to write the expression, so maximum torque equal to K into V by F whole square. So that is, your torque is also remains constant and air gap flux also remains constant. Your motor can also be operates in a constant torque mode. So for low frequency operation at a constant V by F ratio, it's not satisfactory, right? At low frequency operation, we cannot able to determine that V by F ratio, that is a starting and breakdown torque decreases and no load current increases. So due to that, we cannot be able to maintain the constant air gap flux. So air gap flux cannot be maintained constant. So by maintaining V by F ratio to at low frequency operation, so the supply voltage has to be increases, right? So voltage rating, and also we have to take down the care. So voltage value also, voltage magnitude also cannot be increased beyond the rating of the motor. So if I am going to set the voltage rating, that is the 440 volt, means that is I cannot be able to vary the voltage beyond that 440 volt. So if I am going to increase the voltage, it will damage the insulation of the motors, windings, like that. So that we have to take down the additional voltage can also be increased to 110% of the rated value. So 110% of the rated voltage value. So here some expressions are given, torque expressions value also given, some equations are given here. So torque can be written as, already I had given in your offline class mode. So in equivalent circuit mode, all the formulas I had given. So once again, you can go through this. T is T equal to 3 into V square RR dash divided by omega S into RS plus RR dash by S whole square plus XS plus XR dash whole square into S. So here T can be written as, if I am going to write down, that is the K value in terms of multiplied by K. So K square value. So 3 by K omega S into RS plus RR dash A by S whole square plus K square into XS plus XR dash whole square into S. So SM, so maximum slip can be written as plus or minus RR dash divided by square root of RS square plus K square into XS plus XR dash whole square. So you substitute this value, so that SM value, so that the maximum torque can also be achieved. So T max value is given. So starting torque for rated voltage, rated frequency formula is given here, T starting torque. So as well as starting torque for variable voltage, variable frequency, that is V by F control method, that is given here, 3 divided by K into omega S into K square V square by RR dash divided by RS plus RR dash plus K square XS plus XR dash whole square. So here some another formula, starting current for rated voltage, rated frequency formulas are given. And also power factor for rated voltage, rated frequency is also given. For rated voltage, rated frequency, and also V by F control method, so what is the power factor, that is also given here. So speed torque characteristics, so maximum torque can be achieved by the expression, maximum torque T max equal to 3 by 2 into omega S into V square divided by RS plus or minus square root of RS square plus XS plus XR dash whole square, that is K value equal to 1. So maximum torque, so previously we have written T max. So that in that expression we have to make down k is equal to 1 year. So t max can also be written here. So another one in terms of omega s equal to 2 pi f. So based on that we can write the formula here. So and also you substitute the k value ls, that can be taken as stator inductance lr dash equal to rotor inductance referred to stator positive sign for. So here, so we are writing plus or minus formula. So plus for motoring operation, negative sign for braking operation, right? So if rs by f less than 2 pi into ls plus lr dash, so that here rs plus f value, it can be vanished. So that here t max equal to k into v by f whole square divided by 2 pi into ls plus lr dash whole square, right? So for this constant v by f ratio, the motor develops a constant maximum torque, right? So that at low frequency. So at low frequency, we cannot able to achieve this method. For the motor operates in a constant torque type mode. So constant maximum torque. So we are motor develops the constant. If I am going to fix the v by f ratio, right? So here v by f ratio, variable frequency control is value is given. So here characteristics. So from that characteristics, above the base frequency. So here I am going to increase the frequency value up to base frequency. So above the base frequency, the voltage is maintained as a reaches a constant value. At above the base frequency, the motor terminal voltage is constant, right? So at low frequencies, at less than the base frequency, your rated voltage value also increases, slightly increases. That is the triangle. So here, so another one value is here. So V speed torque characteristics is given. So if I am going to maintain a constant V by F ratio control, your characteristics like that. So if I am going to increase the only frequency increases, so V is maintained constant. So what will happen? Your torque value reduces. So maximum torque value reduces. That is the slightly decreases the characteristics. So maximum breakdown torque, so right, decreases. So here another one. So here variable frequency control characteristics is given here. So if I am going to maintain a above the base frequency, your voltage is maintained as a constant and also torque is maintained constant. So if I am going to increase the frequency, what will happen? Your torque value decreases. Your torque value decreases. So that is given in the speed torque characteristics. So what will happen? If I am going to increase the frequency value, what is the characteristics? If I am going to increase the, so V by F value, frequency value, so what is the characteristics look like that? So here I am going to maintain a V is constant here. So increasing the frequency above the base frequency, less than the base frequency like that. So here advantages, it provides a good transient, a good running and a transient response, as well as from zero speed to above speed, we can have the speed control, braking operations also available. So transient period, the operation can also be carried out maximum torque with reduced current with a good dynamic response. So copper losses are low, efficiency and power factors are high, operation is restricted between synchronous speed and maximum torque point. So drop in speed from no load to full load speed is very small. So that is the voltage drop is very, very small. So disadvantages is the cost is very, very high. So in applications, so we can use this V by F control method. So right, so mines, chemical industries, traction, steel mills, pumps, fans, blowers, compressors, conveyors, machine tools, like that. So that we can use that in that applications, we can go for V by F control method, right? So open loop V by F control induction motor is given here. So here induction motor, variable frequency, variable source is given here. So here the variable command V star is taken. So V star and also F star, by making the V star and F star. So F star is the frequency, reference frequency is changed to control speed. So delay circuit is introduced here. So by changing the value of V star and F star, your induction motor speed also can also be varies. So here we can go for a V by a VFVS, instead of VFVS, we can go for a cyclo converter, right? So this is the V by F control. It is the one of the most powerful technique to control the speed control of induction motor. So once again, I am repeating. So here the speed control can be achieved by the two cases. So one is frequency increases, speed increases, T max decreases. So second case, voltage increases, T max increases. So by combining these two features, we are going to achieve a speed control of induction motor. So induction motor by combining these two features. So here by maintaining the V by F ratio is constant, we are going to achieve a steady state point, right? I hope all of you understand this class. So next class we can go for a constant air gap flux control, and another one, constant slip control, is used to control the speed control of induction motor, right? So it will be you can go and refer your textbook. So there will be some MCQ questions will comes under this topic, right? So I hope all of you understand this class. Okay, brothers and sisters, thank you.